So, we are recording. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Right.
Waalaikumsalam. So,
good afternoon. Thank you for coming, everyone, Golden English teachers. So, welcome to our Golden English Teachers Upgrade. This is a part of our Golden English Professional Development, actually. And our topic for today is becoming a Microsoft Certified, Microsoft Educator Certified. Okay, so I hope everyone can see the screen. So actually, we also have our guest speakers. We are going to introduce them, and maybe they will also introduce themselves. So, but for the time being, kindly check your microphone. Make sure that you are muted while the presentation. Okay. There will be a question and answer and also like a discussion session. So for the time being, make sure that your microphone is muted and also you have pretty good connection so you can join us for the best experience. And I think for the opening, we will have a short speech and also brief announcement information from our head of academic, Mr. Firman Aziz. Okay, time is yours.
Okay, so I think it is not considered a speech because it's too short. Okay, so yeah, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, so welcome everyone. Thank you for participating in our teacher upgrade. Yeah, this is one of the series that we have been doing so far. You know about the GETPD, Golden English Teacher Professional Development. So this one is another series of that. Okay, so yeah, my name is Firman Aziz. Yeah, for those who haven't recognized me, so please. I would like to say nice to meet you guys virtually, and this is gonna be this webinar is gonna be interesting and insightful, and it will be gonna be a golden chance for you to elevate your level, your professional level here, because we are talking about Microsoft. Yeah, who doesn't know about Microsoft here? So Microsoft is a prestige branch, and if you are certified Microsoft Innovative Educator certified, that means that you can increase your expectation, your salary expectation maybe, or maybe your professional development here. Well, another is, I would like to say, this is one of the requirements from Golden English for part-time teachers, not only part-time teachers, but also full-time teachers, to be certified by Microsoft, because you know, in this pandemic era, everything has changed dramatically. Well, in the past, we used to be familiar with offline classes, but now everything gonna be online. And yeah, it's really great to have or to experience this such of thing like Microsoft Innovative Educator here. Well, I think again, so this is one of the requirements, and I would like to know about the, you know, Guru Prioritas, we call that. As you know that we have a starting review, and I hope that it works very well, because everyone doing their best performance to our students, so that you can good review, you can get good review from your students, and it will be much more easier, yeah, for part-time teachers to gain or to get job in Golden English anyway. Well, I think that's all from me. Thank you everyone for being here, and thank you again for Mr. Fajar. And I would like to say I do appreciate for guest speakers, Mr. GP and Mr. Felix, okay, for coming here and sharing the knowledge of Microsoft. Thank you everyone, and have a great experience here, webinar. Thank you.
Okay, so thank you very much for the coming speech, Mr. Firman. Right, now I'm going to share my screen again. And because this session, so this presentation will be based on slides and also browsers. But for the time being, let us once again introduce ourselves. Okay, maybe starting by B. Most of you guys have met me, maybe, or maybe like you have attended our session several times. My students usually call me Mr. Fajar, or Fajar is also okay. So I'm also the Golden English Academic Affair and also a Golden English full-time teacher. Here I'm in the Professional Development Division. So you're going to meet me at least like twice or three times a year in a webinar, because like I'm the one who responsible for the professional development for everyone in Golden English, especially in the teachers. Okay, and actually I'm not alone here. So this is the first time that I'm not presenting alone. I have invited my friend, my partners, and also my collaborators, who are John Paul Tardo and also Leonard Felix. They are, I should say, really valuable and also, I should say, expert, of course, and also really insightful in using Microsoft as a teaching tools. And they are, of course, also teachers. Okay, I would like to invite first Mr. GP. Okay, Mr. GP, could you please tell a little bit about yourself?
Hey, thank you, Mr. Fajar, for that opening. I would like to introduce myself first. I am Mr. John Paul Tardo from the Philippines. So I am a high school teacher here at the south part of the Philippines, which is the name of the school is Claret School of Zamboanga City. So I have been chosen as a Microsoft Innovative Educator Expert for the school year, for the year 2021-2022. Okay. Thank you so much for that, Mr. Fajar.
Hey, thank you. Mr. John Paul Tardo here is also Global Classroom Facilitator, where we met each other and we're still working on it. So we are trying to open up the world for our students. Okay, so next one we have my colleague, Mr. Leonard Felix Terix. Mr. Felix, kindly tell a little bit about you.
Hi, everyone. So my name is, as you can see there, Leonard Felix Terik. Now I'm living in Salatiga. If you know, it is located in Central Java. So I'm a Javanese. First of all, I would like to say a bunch of thanks to Mr. Fajar, who has invited me to meet all of great educators here. And of course, this big opportunity for me to share my best practices, and maybe your next opportunity to use the most out of Microsoft tools. I think that's all.
Okay, thank you. So, and also Mr. Felix here is a host of a website, which is fabulousclass.com, which have very a lot of tools, a lot of resources that you can visit. Okay, so in the end of the session, you can visit the website. The name is fabulousclass.com. Okay, so Mr. John and Mr. Paul here, Mr. John and Mr. Felix here will help me. So, and also guide everyone to tell more or less about what is MIE. Okay, what is MIE expert? What is MIE? Okay. Yes, that's what we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about MIE. Okay, next, MIE. So MIE is an abbreviation of Microsoft Innovative Educator, right? So MIE here is not me, or maybe in English you know as noodle, though. MIE is an abbreviation of Microsoft Innovative Educator. So this is a free, so let me emphasize this one. This is free program from Microsoft, okay, to develop, to elevate educators' professional development, like that. So these are free courses, free practice, free, training, and also certification, right? So Microsoft Innovative Educator Program has been running for about 5 years or more. They have been giving a lot of insights, a lot of resources to the teachers, globally, of course, because we know Microsoft. Who don't use Microsoft nowadays, right? I believe that most of you are using Microsoft Windows, Microsoft PowerPoint, Microsoft Word, and etc. And we know that we are using them for our teaching, right? We are using them to facilitate our students to be a media for our materials or for our lessons. So let's make it, let's say, more, okay? Mari kita ambil lebih, not just using them as a tool, but let's be expert. We know that just like Mr. Firman said that, yeah, nowadays we call them educational transformation, right? And this is our chance, our opportunity to share, to discuss about what is Microsoft Innovative Educator Program. Okay, so we're going to present it one by one because we have three main, okay, certification and three main, let's say, a qualification of MIE. The first one is MIE member, Microsoft Innovative Educator, and we have MIE trainer, Microsoft Innovative Educator Trainer, who is here, the representative is Mr. Pelik. And we have MIE expert, Microsoft Innovative Educator expert, who we have the representative here, who is Mr. JP or Mr. John. So I will also invite Mr. John and Mr. Felix to try to describe one by one. So let's start with MIE member. Okay. So this is the first step. This is the first step of becoming an MIE certified or a Microsoft Innovative Educator certified. Okay, so this is a journey of joining a professional learning network. So by joining MIE, it's not like a one-time thing. Bukan suatu hal yang dikerjakan selesai, no. But it's the beginning of a journey. You will meet a lot of friends, a lot of colleagues, okay, globally, just like I've done. Okay, how can I meet Mr. Felix and also Mr. John, okay, in sharing our insights about teaching, about educating, like that, and about, mostly about education, right? And also about global citizenship, digital citizenship, etc. So the requirement to get this certificate is by joining the Microsoft Educator Center. Okay, so that is the website that I'm going to show you today, that we are going to see and access together, is the Microsoft Educator Center, and complete 2 hours of training. Okay, so there will be a lot of courses, free courses, pelatihan-pelatihan gratis yang rekan-rekan semua, all Golden English teachers and everyone, yeah, teachers, educators can take for free. Yeah, can take and finish for free anywhere, anytime. Okay, of course with internet bandwidth, with internet connection. Okay, because it's website based and it's free. Okay, and also actually this webinar training like this is also included. So in the end of this session, okay, in the end of this session, everyone will have the chance, okay, to get this certificate. Okay, if you follow the guidelines and the step that we are going to demonstrate. Okay, so that is for the Microsoft Innovative Educator. Okay, the next one is Microsoft Innovative Educator. So I would like to give Mr. Felix the chance to give insights about what is MIE trainer. Okay, Mr. Felix.
Okay. Yeah. Before at the beginning, Mr. Fajar has shown you the three pages that you and to all of you can get. Yeah. But of course, to get one of these pets needs some requirements, like the first before MIE, and then now it's MIE trainer, and then after that, it's still MIE expert. I would like to explain you about the MIE trainer here. So to start from my own experience, basically, you don't have to pay because it's totally free. It's not like if you know we have the Google certified trainer, which is you need to pay for the basic fundamental course level 1, level 2, and then there's still a trainer assessment, and after that you may apply yourself as the Google certified trainer. But for Microsoft, they offer us a free platform. I can say this is a platform because anyone can access this freely. Yeah, just go to the website. Yeah, I will talk it later. So I just want to point out something here that becoming a trainer means not only a label that I got here, a badge, not only that. I want to give some valuable things to my college, my students, especially becoming a my trainer, just leverage my skill in using Microsoft tools. Who doesn't know this Microsoft tools? Yeah, back then, before the pandemic, we worked with Microsoft Word, PowerPoint, Microsoft Excel before the Google came to transform. Yeah, I can say that Google now still in a higher influence other than the Microsoft, but we do remember that we start everything using Excel, using Word. Yeah. So now it is available. They are available in online. So you can just give a training, anything related to Microsoft. Yeah, we also have some apps, some learning apps. Maybe you ever use it, like Flipgrid. Yeah, they work together. Yeah, so Flipgrid is the products of Microsoft. So yeah, simply teach anyone who you want to know about Microsoft tools. Then after that, there's something you need to do, like record your training. And then, like you see, as many as 100 educators, then it will, they will reward you. They will reward you with this badge as a trainer. But it's not the end. When you got this, then I'm done with this. Yeah, they will check our activity each year. Yeah, so between this month, you have to send or you have to put, you have to post how many educators that you have been teaching, like so. Okay, I think that's just a brief of my trainer. Thanks, Mr.
Okay, so like, MIE certified means that you are a member of a Microsoft Innovative Educator. MIE trainer means that you are a trainer of MIT, just like here. So we are giving training about what is Microsoft Innovative Educators and how to use them, how to make use of Microsoft Innovative Educators. And also there are certain requirements that you have to do before you can gain the MIE trainer, which is that you have to at least train 100 people. Like that. And just like Mr. Felix said, it's not after you train 100 people, you get the certificate, it's not the end, right? So you're going to continuously share your expertise, share your insights about what is MIT, what is Microsoft in education, like that. And also how you can make use of the technology to transform the framework of education, the framework of teachings, and also transform the class, especially during this time. Like that. So MIE trainer means that you are the trainer of Microsoft. Okay, so next one, we have MIE expert. So just like the name, it's expert. So there are things that you have to do first to be this certified. Okay, I would like to find out Mr. John to explain a little bit about this.
Okay, thank you so much for that, Mr. Fajar. So Microsoft Innovative Educator Expert. So what does this mean? So every year, Microsoft selects innovative educator experts to be part of this exclusive global community of this paving the way for their peers to share ideas, try new approaches, and learn from each other. So the difference between a member, a trainer, and a expert. So in member, you are a member, so you will have the opportunity to learn with their different courses in the platform. For a trainer, you have the opportunity to teach or to train other educators, school leaders in your community. But for experts, you get to attend exclusive global events. So how to be part of a Microsoft Innovative Educator Expert. So as a requirements there, you can see that there is a become an MIE by completing a 2 hours of training. So that is to become a member, which is the first part of this session. So you will be chosen as an MIE expert if you have completed the self-nomination form from that from the platform. Okay. So if you are self-driven, passionate about your work, have true collaborative spirit, and strive to inspire students with outside the box thinking on technology of education. Sir, what is the difference between MIE trainer and MIE expert? So for MIE expert, the commitment there is you will be the agents of change. You will be excellent in education using technology and social media. Then what are the benefits of being an MIE expert? So honestly, you get to enjoy free premium accounts valid for 1 year with the partners of Microsoft Innovative Educator Expert. But I am really sorry, but I am not allowed to divulge who are our partners. But rest assured, you will really enjoy having a exclusive free premium accounts with these different partners of Microsoft. And a while ago, I was saying about the global exclusive global events. So what are these? So you can actually even host an event, conferences, or an MIE Tech Meet. You can conduct that. And we can attend also the welcome call. So if you're an MIE expert, you can have it, get to know the educators around the world. And Microsoft Global Learning Connection, so which will be held every November with your class. You can meet other classes around the world. Then, and what I love the most, the event that we really love when you are part of the MIE Expert is the education exchange that is happening every March 22 and 24. So that's it. There are a lot of, exclusive global events that only MIE Expert can experience. So what are you waiting for? Together with Mr. Fajar, we can complete the MIE membership, then proceed with trainer and become an expert.
Thank you very much, Mr. John. Yeah, so actually in MIE community where I met Mr. John and we met other educators around the world, and we conduct online meeting with our students once a week, mostly about English conversation. So we bring our students and the students meet each other, right? Okay, and talk about their countries, talk about their schools, like that. Okay, now let's go to the demos, all right? So this is a short guidelines, okay, for logging into or signing up for MEC. So MEC is an abbreviation of Microsoft Educator Center. So it's really easy, it's free, all right? You can access it anytime, anywhere with mobile connection or maybe internet connection. So I will copy and paste this into the chat in case that you want to follow me, open it in your browser. Okay, so you're going to go to the website itself. I copy and paste it in the chat. If you want to open it on your browser, it's great. But if you just want to see it from my screen, it's also okay. So I'll click this one. Everyone will get this slide, of course, in the end of the session. Okay. Oh, sorry. Okay, because I already logged in. So this is the website, Microsoft Educator Center. So you don't need to pay. You don't need to have account. All right, you can access it without account. But if you want to have a profile, of course you get account. Jadi ini bisa diakses tanpa akun. Tapi tentu saja, if you want to get the courses, pelatihan-pelatihan, ataupun update dari website ini, you need an account. Okay. And it's, I should say, original, of course, from Microsoft. Okay, and you can navigate. We have training here. We have lesson plans, which is basically mostly about STEM, science, technology, engineering, maths, right? We have Minecraft for education. And also we have the programs, which the first one, of course, Microsoft Innovative Educator Programs, and they have a lot of products which we can use for free like that, and we can use in our class. And maybe next time in the next session, we can try everything one by one. But in this session, we can just see how we can create an account here. Okay, so firstly, I would like to copy and paste this into Incognito browser. So I will demonstrate how to create an account. Okay, because in this browser I already have my account. Okay, so I will try to navigate to my profile. Okay, so this is my profile. Okay, click it. Okay, so here in this profile you can see all the certificate that you have. So you will, you don't have to be afraid. Jadi nggak usah takut sertifikatnya hilang atau kehapus filenya. As long as you have the account, selama akunnya masih ada, sertifikatnya akan tetap ada. Like that, yeah. And also of course it cannot be fake. Tidak bisa dipalsukan. Misalkan, oh saya tinggal edit saja namanya. Oh, I will try to edit the PDF. Saya ganti aja namanya. Okay, but you need an account. Okay, oh, nanti bisa dilihat akunnya ada nggak? Jika sertifikatnya terdaftar nggak? Sampai nggak? So I'm going to show, this is actually my second account. This is for, we say, sandbox account. Yeah, akun pelatihan. So this is the certificate of Microsoft Innovative Educator as a member. Okay, as a member. And also, what makes it great, sekarang sekolah-sekolah sudah banyak yang menggait sekolah teknologi, we say educational technology school, karena ini bisa di-convert ke jam pelatihan. Karena mereka punya transkrip. Mereka punya transkrip seperti ini. Dan biasanya ini berbayar, rekan-rekan semua. This is what we want to share here. Yeah? Because the access is free, tapi biasanya pelatihannya yang berbayar. Begitu. Jika rekan-rekan nanti bisa tanya, teman-teman yang sudah pernah ikut, itu biasanya didanai oleh pemerintah atau oleh Kemendikbud. But here we want to share it for free, like that. So you have the transcript on your own. Okay. So the transcript will count all of your certificate by hours. Nah, biasanya ini bekerja sama dengan sekolah edukasi teknologi untuk di-convert ke jam pelatihan seperti itu. Okay. Now let me navigate to the Incognito browser. Right. Okay. Can you see the Incognito browser, Mr. Felix? Incognito ya, sudah ya? Okay. Nah, so what you should do is to click sign in here. Okay. Click sign in. And it will direct you to this page. Dia akan muncul ke halaman ini. Gimana yang harusnya sign in. But if you don't have account yet, kalau belum punya akun, you can create one. Nah, pakai apa bikinnya? You can use your Gmail. Rekan-rekan bisa pakai email yang sudah ada. Tentang ini Microsoft, jangan-jangan nggak bisa pakai Node. Bisa pakai Gmail. So you can use Gmail, you can use maybe you still have Yahoo, ya bisa pakai Yahoo. Atau mungkin punya email yang punya domain sendiri. Seperti Mas Felix, ya. Emailnya udah bukan Gmail, udah bukan Outlook. Ya. Emailnya udah fabulousclass.com. Atau mungkin Golden English, untuk administrasi kita pakai Golden English. course.com. Nah, jadi rekan-rekan, you can use your own personal email, okay, to create an account. Tapi misalkan, I want a new email. Saya mau buat email baru. You can get a new email address. Yang pastinya emailnya bukan Gmail, tapi melainkan Outlook. Nah, mungkin di sini it's uncommon, masih belum familiar. Jadi kita menggunakan Outlook. Jadi Outlook itu email versi Microsoft. Kita kan seringnya pakai Gmail ya, Google Mail. Tapi Microsoft juga sudah punya email. Sudah lebih dulu ya, lebih dulu Microsoft, mereka punya Outlook. Seperti itu. Now I will demonstrate here using my Outlook account. So I will just demonstrate using existing account. Okay. Outlook.id. Okay. Oh, reset domain, please enter a different. Oh, udah ada ini. Okay, we just get new email address. So as example, if you want to create a new email, you can create new and you can choose between Outlook or Hotmail. Okay, for example, I say Golden English. Okay. Outlook.com. Some already udah ada yang punya. Okay, wait. Let's say English Tech. Aduh, Mas Felix punya email lain yang belum dipakai kesini? Saya lupa nyiapin email nih. Okay, what is it, Mas Felix? Di chat saja, saya copy paste. Ada nggak, Mas Felix?
Ya, nggak ada.
Oke, got it. Jadi saya lupa hapus akun. chat ini saja ya, private. Okay. So the thing is that you can create an account if you have not yet had an account. Kalau belum punya akun bisa buat akun dulu. Tapi setelah punya akun nanti bisa langsung sign in saja seperti biasa. Just like to another platform, just like to another social media. Itu. And of course everything will be sent to your email. Gitu ya. As a sample like update atau misalnya ada perubahan sesuatu it will be sent to your email. Muncul Mas Ferik? Lu masuk saya.
Okay, just okay. A moment.
Okay. Okay, I will just show. Wait. Kind of forgot if I have ever used this one or not. Outlook.id. This is part of the supplement. Udah berarti udah punya ini. Okay, wait. Okay, let's talk about sign in. Okay, if you want to sign in, you can just put out your email. Okay, as example, I'm using the email from Spellik at pebblesclass.com. There you go, next. Like that. Okay. Yes. Okay. Then you can go directly to the account. So if you have not yet had an account, you create a new one. And it's really easy. Jadi kalau udah ada emailnya, tinggal digunakan email. Email yang memang belum punya akun. Tadi karena emailnya sudah punya akun, jadi tidak bisa buat baru ya. Langsung sign in. Something like that. Okay. So mostly, so you can navigate to training and you can click courses. Nah, nanti di kursus-kursus ini, teman-teman bisa pilih rekan-rekan semua Golden English Teachers. Okay, you can choose the courses which are interested to you. Yang memang menarik. Yang teman-teman mungkin oh, I think I need this in my school. I need this in my teaching. Yeah. So they have several types. Jadi ada yang berbentuk course, ada yang berbentuk learning path. Nah, kalau learning path itu seperti jurusan, di mana satu jurusan ini berisi beberapa kursus. Seperti itu. As example, this one. Okay, so they have several courses. Okay, like this. They have several courses. And it's really easy to do the course. Okay, as example, this one, connect faculty and learners with Canvas and Microsoft. It's really easy. You only have to watch videos. You only have to read the materials. And in the end, you only have to do the quiz. Okay. Oh, saya belum login. Okay, I will navigate to another account. Wait. Go back to this one. So you only have to navigate to courses, lalu pilih kursus yang memang rekan-rekan tertarik. Seperti itu. Yang memang, oh, I think I know this and I would like to learn more. Yeah. Okay, let's say choose the most familiar one. Okay, enrich the learning experience in Microsoft Edge. Nah, ini Microsoft Edge ini browser updatean dari Microsoft. Kalau sebelumnya kita tahu Internet Explorer, nah sekarang udah update jadi Microsoft Edge. Dan Microsoft Edge ini berbasis Google Chrome juga, jadi nggak lelet-lelet amat. And actually I'm using Microsoft Edge karena Google Chrome agak berat biasanya, so I'm using Microsoft Edge. Nah, ketika kursusnya selesai, there will be this sign, yeah, course completed. Okay, jadi teman-teman juga bisa share. Misalnya, oh, I want to share my completion to social media. You can share to Facebook, Twitter. Yeah, maybe if you want to discuss with your friend. Tapi teman-teman juga, rekan-rekan semua, oh saya mau lihat lagi kursusnya, saya ada yang lupa. You can click the take course again. And in the course, you only have to yeah, watch videos. And I'm pretty sure if you watch it closely, carefully, it will be really beneficial. Yeah? Terutama untuk penggunaan-penggunaan aplikasi. Seperti itu. Dan bagaimana pengaplikasiannya di dalam kelas. Because this is what it's for. I mean like, this is what it's about. Memang tentang ini. And after you do the quiz, okay, and the quiz is really easy. All the quizzes are multiple choices. Semua quiznya adalah pilihan ganda. And you can do it again and again. Rekan-rekan bisa ulang lagi. Misalkan, this is 80% to pass. Minimal 80%. oh ternyata cuma benar 3. Berarti kan 60%. Bisa ulang lagi. Sometimes the question change. Terkadang pertanyaannya berganti, tapi terkadang tidak. So, yeah, make sure this is just to learn. Okay? I mean like the real things, hal sebenarnya adalah ketika memang kita praktikan atau aplikasikan dalam pengajaran kita. In our teaching, like that. And to get the MIE certificate, you as a member, you need to be at least finish tadi ya, 2 jam. Okay, 2 jam itu maksudnya seperti apa? Example here, Education for a Sustainable World. Kita klik sertifikatnya. Nanti ada yang kita tahu sebagai JP, ya, jam pelatihan. Nah, di sini ada estimated duration 1 hour. Nah, berarti kita harus menyelesaikan kursus yang seperti ini minimal 2. Nanti akan muncul sertifikat yang ini. Seperti itu. Okay, any question so far? Maybe if you want to ask it in the chat, that's okay. About accessing the website itself, tentang mengakses situs ini atau halaman jaringan ini, this webpage or this platform, or maybe any additional tambahan, Mr. John or Mr. Felix, yang luput mungkin tadi. Okay. Bagaimana rekan-rekan terkait website-nya dulu? You can unmute or maybe in the chat. Okay. Real example such as real example bagaimana Mas Mr. Eddy? Is there any problem if someone use Microsoft Pak Tani? No problem. In teaching. Okay. Actually, yeah, we want to have a session for using Microsoft tools in teaching, yeah. But I don't think it will be enough for the time for today. Banyak sekali yang bisa digunakan dalam mengajar, terutama Flipgrid. Waktunya tidak akan cukup, sayangnya. Nanti ada Flipgrid yang saya biasa pakai untuk speaking test. Nanti ada juga OneDrive and a lot of things. Yes, dan tentunya masih banyak seperti Microsoft PowerPoint. Microsoft Word yang bisa digunakan dalam pengajaran. In teaching, let's say I want to improve my vocabulary student. Okay, we're going to discuss about it next session, yeah, hopefully. Okay. Okay, this is a certification session first. Okay, thank you, Mr. Eddy. That's a pretty good idea, yeah. Okay, hopefully next session. Okay, about the website first. Untuk Mr. Wardoyo tadi, no, we don't have any problem. Ketika mengakses ini menggunakan yang memang Microsoft yang let's say unlicensed, yang tidak berlisensi, karena ini diaksesnya secara online. And of course you can access this website through your phone. Rekan-rekan bisa akses di HP, ya, dengan website yang sama, cara login yang sama, seperti itu. Misalkan, oh saya mau jalanin kursus, lagi nunggu apa nih? I want to take a course from Microsoft. Gitu. I want to read a new update. Rekan-rekan bisa masuk saja browser HP, langsung educationmicrosoft.com. Login, and yeah, it's okay. Like that. Okay. Okay, anything else? Untuk Mr. Eddy, I hope we can do it next time, okay? In the next session, especially for teaching. Teaching session. Is it mandatory for us to be certified with MEC? It is expected. Okay, just like Mr. Firman said. Is Mr. Firman still here? Okay, just like Mr. Firman said, it is expected for all Golden English teachers to be at least certified as an MIE. First, as a requirement and qualification, so you know that our institution, lembaga kita punya yang namanya akreditasi, ya kan? Dan yang namanya semua lembaga punya akreditasi, especially education institution, lembaga pendidikan. Dan yang namanya akreditasi ya, semua dicek. Pekerjanya, organisasinya, and this is what we are hoping for, right? By branding our teachers as a Microsoft Innovative Educator, so we hope we can gain more students, right? Oh yeah, Golden English teachers are certified Microsoft, so the students are no longer worried if they want to take online teaching. Oh, orang udah Microsoft certified, tentu saja, itu kan mengajar online-nya sudah mumpuni, seperti itu. Ya, meskipun tanpa Microsoft Innovative Educator Certificate, Memang kita sudah mumpuni, but at least we need the proof. Ini yang kita sebut branding kan ya, rekan-rekan semua. Kita butuh bukti. Ya, as example ya, our students, they have a very good English. They want to go abroad, still they need to take IELTS. Gitu kan, masih harus ambil TOEFL atau IELTS dan segala macamnya. Meskipun bahasa Inggrisnya udah bagus banget tuh. Same like us. Even though that our teaching, let's say extraordinary, but we need proof, which is qualification from a credible organization. And here we have Microsoft for our session today. Okay? Okay, Teacher Ju? Do you want to ask something?
Hi, sir.
Yes?
Yeah, I have something to ask. It's a very quick question.
Mm-hmm.
Can I become certified for Microsoft Office at a local school, or does it always have to be online?
Oh, actually, you can be certified by following a training like this. Yeah. So there will be a redeem code. Jadi untuk rekan-rekan, as example, oh, I don't want to take the course. Saya nggak biasa menjalankan pelatihan-pelatihan yang self-paced. Gitu kan, pelatihan-pelatihan yang asinkronus. Saya biasanya pelatihan yang memang berbasis webinar atau sinkronus seperti ini. Yes, you can. Yeah. As example here from Mr. Felix. Mr. Felix is, what is it? Let's say accredited or maybe recognized. Mr. Felix ini di recognized by Microsoft to give certificate for the educators. Jadi misal nanti Mr. Felix ini, Mas Felix menjalankan pelatihan, as example about OneDrive or maybe about Microsoft Office, Mr. Felix can also give certificate through this website. Nah, itu yang namanya we have redeem achievement code. Nah, ini. So you can get certificate without taking the self-paced course dengan syarat mengikuti pelatihan yang sinkronus. Nanti teman-teman, you rekan-rekan semua, you will get a code. Nah, di mana ketika kode dimasukkan, di redeem sertifikatnya langsung muncul di profil tanpa menjalani pelatihan. Tetap menjalani pelatihan, tapi pelatihannya yang bukan self-paced gitu. Ya. Dan tetap every certificate is based on this platform. Jadi sertifikatnya semua tetap dikumpulkan di website ini gitu. Ya. For the credibility. Nah, di sini kan ada kredibilitasnya ya. Kalau misalkan dulu ya we rely on signature, we rely on what is it? Stempel. Ya, kita dulu kan cap tanda tangan, sekarang we have credential link gitu, credential profile. Di mana sertifikat ini bisa dibuktikan asli karena kita punya profil di situs tersebut. Gitu. Okay, is that answering your question, Mr. Ju?
Yeah, what you said helps a lot. Thank you.
Okay. Okay. Anything else? Anybody? Or maybe Mr. Felix, Mr. John, you want to add something about taking the courses here?
Mr. Fajar, I will not add anything. I just want to share my experience. Would it be okay?
Yeah, sure.
So first, I was, what do you call this? Skeptic on what is this Microsoft Education Center. So same with you guys, fellow professionals, I was also skeptic, what is this? My fellow teacher here introduced it to me. How can I become a Microsoft Innovative Educator? So Mr. Almark showed to me this one. So I just take a course and become an MIE member. That's how easy it is. So you just, as what Mr. Fajar said, you just log in using your account, your email, then you take some courses. Why would you like that? Why will you take some courses? Because at some point, like for example, if we are teaching online and we would like to learn more about Teams, in our school, we are, what do you call this, teaching students via Microsoft Teams. It's similar to Zoom, but more integrated with how we deliver our lessons. So with this, if I do not know any more about Teams, so I'll just browse here and look for that course and to study Microsoft Teams. That is how I learn different Microsoft tools. So if you have questions about how to use Microsoft PowerPoint, much better. So you can look for courses in this platform. That's it. Thank you so much.
Okay. Yeah, it's a pretty good one. Yeah. So for those who are, I should say, integrated to PLN or Professional Learning Network. So nowadays people are learning by their own, especially teachers and educators. We know a self-paced learning, ya, belajar mandiri. Especially we call them in what is it, self-paced professional development framework. So as example, you want to use Microsoft Teams, or maybe you want to use Microsoft Word. So you can just click Word here in the course, and you can find a lot of things related to the things that you want to learn based on Microsoft. For example, you want to use Office in your classroom. There's a lot of it, especially, right? And back in the days, we know them as Microsoft Office. Yeah, but it's changed. Sekarang sudah ganti namanya ya, Mas Felix. Bukan Microsoft Office, tapi Office 365, Office 365. Betul, Mas Felix?
Ya, yeah, Mas Ajar.
Oke. Okay. Ada apa aja di Office 365 ini?
Ya sebenarnya ada dua versi ya, sebenarnya ada versi yang terbaru. Jadi sebelum masa online ini apa namanya booming, dulu kita pakai produk yang Microsoft Office ya, di mana dalamnya ada Excel, Microsoft Word, terus PowerPoint, ada Visio, macam-macam ya yang bawaan di biasanya langsung terinstall di desktop ya. Nah, yang Office 365 ini sebenarnya hadir dua versi, yang online sama yang apa namanya offline. Cuma yang offline ini berbayar. Ya, offline ini berbayar, kita harus bayar per tahun ya, dan cukup mahal. Jadi yang kita pakai, yang kalau misalkan kita buat langsung di web, itu yang kita bisa pakai secara free ya untuk apa namanya Office 365. Cuma beberapa saja sih, kalau institusi biasanya mereka punya lisensi khusus untuk Office 365 yang apa namanya online, lalu ada juga yang offline. Tetapi toolsnya dalamnya sama, hanya beda sedikit-sedikit aja sih antara Microsoft Office sama Office 365.
So let's say like Office 365 is the version of Google Docs and Google Drive.
Yeah.
So Google, we have Google Drive, we have Google Docs, Google Slide. Yeah. In Office 365, we have PowerPoint online. So what's the benefit of using online tools? Yeah. The thing is with using online tools, it's synchronous. Itu kan biasanya kalau pakai Microsoft Word, kita ngetik, kita simpan, kita kirim. Nanti yang lain ngetik. But in Microsoft Word online, itu teman-teman rekan-rekan, we and our students can type down at the same time. As example, we want to collaborate in writing. Yeah, I heard our other teachers, Mr. Lutfi, he is teaching IELTS, and he collaborate with his students, yeah, in what is it, writing practice to write short story in Microsoft Word online. So they write a short story together to practice their vocabulary in writing and also structure and etc. So the thing with online tools is you can do it collaboratively, yeah, without having to download, save, download, send file, download again, but it will be in the cloud. So like in Google we have Google Drive, in Microsoft we have OneDrive, like that. Okay, well, if there's, I think it's really clear, yeah, about how using Educator Center website. So what you should do is go to the website, sign in with an account or sign up with your email. Okay, you can just click sign in, then you will have your profile, you can change your photo, yeah, and you can also have a full profile, and you can add it to your CV, of course. Yeah, you can add your Microsoft profile to the CV, okay, or maybe or any professional development career portfolio that you have. As example, if you use another account and you click create account and you enter your email, pass, set up a password, and it's done. Okay, unfortunately, you don't have new email yet. Emailnya terpakai semua. Okay, now let's go back to the slide for a moment. Oh no, this one. Oh, where is my slide? Oh, sorry. So you will get this slide later on, and I'm pretty sure that it's already clear. except you have more questions, you can ask it now. Okay, so next one, the benefits. Okay, so now we're going to talk fully or discuss it fully, completely about the benefits. Okay. Okay, let's start from me. So what I got, what I experienced of becoming an MIE member or knowing the MIE website and mengetahui MEC, Microsoft Educator Center. Of course, I learn more and it gives me a lot of confidence. Yeah. Banyak kepercayaan dirian. Yeah. So it's not about getting certified or I have certificate. No, but sometimes, most of the times for me, yeah, because you have the certificate, you have the confidence. Yeah. Punya kepercayaan dirinya, oh, I have the certificate. I'm certified, I'm qualified to talk about this. I'm qualified to do this, as example. And for me, it gives me more curiosity. Yeah, lebih banyak rasa penasaran. Oh, I want to explore more, right? I want to share more. Just like here, Mr. John and Mr. Felix, I can invite them to talk with us, discuss with us about education. So as example, Mr. John, what do you teach, Mr. John? I'm sorry, I forgot. In your school.
I am teaching mathematics and business subjects.
So Mr. John is teaching maths, not English. Okay. So this is not just for English teachers. Ini bukan hanya untuk guru bahasa Inggris. Yeah. So Mr. John, he is teaching math. All right. And I'm pretty sure there's a lot of application that you can use to teach math. Or maybe to teach English. Okay. As example, you have a mathematics education student. Nah, kita kan banyak mahasiswa. Mahasiswa pendidikan matematika. We can also teach them how to use this website because this website is only in English. Kita sudah coba otak-atik, there is no other language version. Is it correct? Mr. John, have you ever seen other version of language of MEC website?
Yes.
Okay. So it's also only in English. How about Mr. Felix? What do you teach?
Currently, I teach primary students. For math, social studies, and science. So no English also.
No English also, okay. Primary students are the best teachers. They teach a lot of subjects. Yeah. So the benefits that I experience all this time that I get to know more about education, it's not just about my subject, not just about English, but a lot of things. And especially teaching in our institution, like in language center, we don't just teach English. But we guide people, we guide learners, we give them access, okay, to the things that they have the barrier to the language. Jadi biasanya kita tidak hanya belajar ajar bahasa Inggris ya, tapi give them access yang tadinya mereka tidak bisa akses karena language barrier. I'm pretty sure most of you, everyone, Golden English great teachers ya, pasti pernah dapat murid, doctor, ya, education students, mahasiswa pendidikan atau mahasiswa offers. Ya. Professionals, I'm pretty sure. Okay, so it's not just about teaching English personally as I experience, but it to give them access to the global world, which is English, is the lingua franca. Okay, how about Mr. Felix, your the benefits that you say achieve or maybe like experience to this day by knowing Microsoft Educator Center?
Yeah, so first, becoming the Microsoft Innovative Integrator, I want to emphasize the word innovative, like be original and be creative as well. So yeah, because I teach students, then something that I need to focus on is it's not only me in the classroom that will be a creative one. It's you and your students, right? So like Mr. Fajar said before, by giving them access to really experience their English learning experience to the next level. So what I've been experiencing with my student is joining the MGLC, if you ever heard, it's Microsoft Global Learning Connection. But last year is the last. Last year was the last event from Microsoft. I do not know why they stopped that event, because they tried to transfer that event with
Mas Balik having an connection problem. Okay, so MGLC, Microsoft Global Learning Connection, is where you can meet educators from different countries. Okay, we already have an example here. I met Mr. John because our MIE community, we also bring our students once a week, okay, to talk about discussion. So you can also try to invite your teacher friends from another country, which they also have students who want to learn English. And also you can try to have a collaboration for your students and the students from another country, and especially through the teachers. Okay. Yeah, the benefits cannot be quantified in value or such. And the thing is, this is free. That's the amazing one for us. Okay. So about you, Mr. John, what can you share the benefits of being an MIE expert, especially?
Okay, so since it's just a few days since we were announced as to be, we are the Microsoft Innovative Educator Expert for this year, 2021-2022, we were not yet, enjoyed the free offers. So I would like to say to you that we have free premium offers if you are an MIE expert. So for example, let's say you have Kahoot. Let me drop down the name. Kahoot. Are you familiar with Kahoot? It's a game application, right? Wherein you can let the students answer activities, but in a gamification type. So in our end, if we are not an MIE expert, we can only experience the free Kahoot. But if you're an MIE expert, the great benefit there is you can actually enjoy premium account. That's exclusively given to Microsoft Innovative Educator Expert. Yeah. Then also, as a benefit, as a teacher here, because of the Microsoft Innovative Educator, we are conducting, share also our knowledge to our fellow teachers here in our school.
Okay. Yeah, I heard about it. So starting from this year, MIE Expert will get premium access to Kahoot, right? Yeah, because... Yeah. Yeah, because I'm a Kahoot certified, but not yet MIE expert. So for those who get Kahoot verified academy, and also now starting from this year, MIE expert, you will get 1 year, is it?
Yeah, 1 year.
1 year premium Kahoot, where you can use all the features in Kahoot. Okay. All right, so far, any questions about the benefits or maybe anything related to MIE? Of the qualification. So today we're just talking about the qualification first, and the next session, hopefully when every teacher here is already MIE certified member, so we can discuss more about using the application in the class. Okay. Then in the discussion maybe about being MIE, you can turn on your microphone or you can chat in the Zoom chat. Sounds okay. They're still thinking. Okay, Miss Nadia, maybe. So we have Miss Nadia, Miss Aisa, as a full timer, Miss Indra. So we have our full timers here. Okay, I think Miss Aisa is not yet connected to audio. Okay, let's call. Okay, it's Poppy, Mr. Dede. Mr. Gita, any questions? Or it's really clear?
It's clear, sir.
It's clear.
I think I'm waiting for the practice.
Oh, waiting for the practice.
Okay. Yes.
Great, yeah. So, okay, so I think we can go to the next one. Oh, there's chat here.
Okay,
Mr. Chu. Okay, I hope with this you can have a clearer future. Okay, so just like I have promised, we have a code here. Okay, so after you create an account, after you create an account in the Microsoft Educator Center, you can redeem this account. Okay, so you can click on your profile and redeem code. Okay, and you can redeem this code. Okay, so you can type it down now because okay, let's say I will type it down in the chat. I will not send this after the meeting. Okay, all right. Okay, so make sure you take a screenshot, or maybe oh yeah, you will get this slide. You will get this slide. So you can redeem this code and you will get the MIE certificate directly. Okay, without taking the course because you already joined the this training as your proof to become what is it in participating in Microsoft Educators. Okay, or maybe any question? Ada yang mau tanya gimana cara masukin kodenya? It's already in the slide, yeah. So redeem achievement. Go to educationmicrosoft.com. You can sign in, sign up if you have not yet an account. Yeah, you don't have account yet, belum punya akun. Then select redeem achievement code under the profile and enter this code. Okay, and you will directly get the certificate. Okay. But of course, pretty sure I encourage you all to take the courses that are provided by the MEC, Microsoft Educator Center. And I believe it will, give us more, confidence in using technology, not just Microsoft. Tidak hanya Microsoft sebenarnya, tapi juga ya lebih pede lah menggunakan teknologi-teknologi. Because we are qualified, okay, by the credible institution. Okay. Nah, I think so. It's sooner than I thought. Yeah, it's sooner than I thought because it's really clear. We're just talking about Google application. Nah, this one is our next series. This is not from Golden. Oh, Miss Riana udah dapat. Miss Riana, hello. Bisa unmute?
Ya, yeah, Mister.
Udah dicoba?
Ya. Yeah.
Udah dimasukin kodenya?
Ya, yeah, already.
Dapat. No, you got the certificate.
I got it.
Okay, congratulations. All right. So I hope everyone can try to get the certificate by the redeem code. And I also encourage you to keep on exploring, navigating on the courses. I believe it will be very beneficial for everyone. And also share about this. Ya, ya silakan rekan-rekan bisa apa? Ah yes, congrats ya, Mr. Wardoyo. Okay, rekan-rekan. Share this to your teacher friends, not just English teachers. Okay, not just English teachers. Okay, and this is the last, the next series. This is not from, this is for everyone, not just Golden English teachers. It's coming soon, ya, segera hadir. Jadi yang satu ini bukan hanya untuk guru bahasa Inggris, but I and some MIE from Indonesia, beberapa Microsoft Innovative Educator dari Indonesia ingin menjangkau, we want to reach every educators, every teachers in Indonesia to know about this website, to know about this access. Because this is free, this is a very great opportunity to share and to collaborate with every teachers. Okay, so what if I need to change my name? Can I redeem twice? You have to change account, okay? You can redeem the redeem the code with different account. Ya, misalkan rekan-rekan akun yang satunya salah namanya, bisa ganti akun. But my redeem code is available for 100 participant. Ya, jadi redeem code yang saya bagikan itu hanya bisa dipakai 100 orang, 100 participants. Jadi kalau di sini kan ada sekitar only 40 ya, sekitar 40. Jadi nggak akan habis lah. Gitu. Akan habis ya. So the code is only what is it, available for 100 participants. Nah, ini untuk rekan-rekan yang punya teman-teman guru, ya, tidak hanya guru bahasa Inggris. But every teachers and every subjects who want to, let's say, update to the current trend, to the current technology, please tell about this information. Okay, so it's a micro training series dari beberapa MIE dari Indonesia. So we want to reach more teachers, we reach more educators, not just English. Of course, about MIE, about educational technology. Nanti rekan-rekan bisa bagikan slide ini ke semuanya, tidak hanya guru Google English atau tidak hanya guru bahasa Inggris, ya. Nanti bisa akses likelet.com at microtraining or pebulusclass.com. Ini juga pebulusclass.com is the website. The website is owned or hosted by Mr. Felix. Okay, jadi ini website-nya Mas Felix, and you can also browse this website to check the current technology, the current application to be used in the class. Okay, and of course, they are open access, okay, or free. Okay, so we want to reach, we want to help, we want to assist as much or as many as educators in Indonesia and also globally. Okay, well, actually, that's all we can share for today. Thank you for your, what is it, participation. We really appreciate your participation in our training, pelatihan kita yang memang berseris, berkala. So, we try to make it at least 3 months. I'm sorry, once in 3 months, 3 bulan sekali, seperti itu. Dan ada 2 series, series kualifikasi, ya, yang dimana berbagi tentang seperti ini, about certificate. And also the series of what is it? Sharing technique, ya, alat-alat digital yang bisa digunakan dalam pengajaran. Jadi we will in Golden English for all the teachers. How can I change my name? Okay. Untuk mengganti nama MEC, you access it in your Microsoft account. Okay, wait. Itu belum mudahan. Okay, wait. Let me sign in again. For those who want to change their name, you can go to your profile. Wait. I have to sign in again. Okay, you can go to your profile. Oh, wait. Oh, not here, yeah. Where can I change my name, Mr. John? In Microsoft, in Office. I forgot. Mr. John, how can we change our name? In MEC, I forgot. I think it's in Office 365. Oh, no. So if you want to change your name, you can go to office.com. Okay. Karena memang profilnya, the profile is terintegrasi dengan profil Office. Jadi teman-teman, untuk yang namanya mungkin karena sign up atau mendaftar menggunakan Gmail, jadi ngikut nama Gmail, itu teman-teman ke office.com, you go to office.com and you click your profile. Here. Ya, nanti akan muncul profile, bisa view account. Jadi you go to office.com. You go to office.com and you see my profile. Ya, bisa klik Microsoft logo juga, betul. Thank you Mr. Priyo ya. You can go to you can click the Microsoft logo and it will direct you to this. Nah, nanti ini bisa diganti namanya. Okay. Nanti ini bisa diganti. Alright. Nah, kayaknya enggak bisa diganti karena ini domain fabulous. So you can change the name here. Okay, in the office.com, or maybe you can just like Mr. Priyo said, you click this Microsoft. Now you will go to microsoft.com and you go to your profile and you can edit your profile. So you can edit your name, you can edit your photo and anything, just like making social media. Ya, yeah, seperti buat akun sosial media saja, dilengkapi. Yeah. Anything else? Ada lagi rekan-rekan semua? Thank you, Mr. Frio, for your help. Yes. Nih ya, nanti bisa login lagi. Masih satu yang Gmail. Nah, begitu ya, Miss Balda ya. Miss Balda, you can click the Microsoft logo. Okay, thank you, Mr. Ju. Thank you for your applause. Okay, great. So we have Miss, who is this? Miss Tri. Hello, Miss Tri, are you here? Miss Tri is chatting me on WhatsApp. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what happened?
I tried to sign in, mm-hmm. but it failed.
Oh, sign in or sign up?
Sign in.
Ah, ntar kalau belum punya akun, kalau belum punya akun, sign up.
Oh, iya, yeah, iya. Yeah. I mean sign up.
Oh, sign up. Okay, let's move again.
Okay, so what should I do first?
Okay.
I go to Microsoft.
Yes, educationmicrosoft.com. Then you go to the sign in button on the top right.
Yeah. Right?
Mm-hmm.
But it said that this account doesn't find my account.
Okay. Have you tried check the spelling or anything? Is it really clear?
I guess so.
Okay. Because it's like, you know, case sensitive. Okay. Let's try to check the uppercase or lowercase. Okay, or I mean, like, if it still occur, I suggest you to create new account with a new email address, or maybe try to use another email like that.
Oh, see.
Okay, or maybe you can try to
I'll try.
You can get a new email from Outlook, so you can click get new email address, and you can enter your.
So if I have problem, may I ask you some questions?
Sure.
You know, right? Because I'm gapek.
This is what the training for, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. So this I would like to try.
Okay.
So
great.
If I find a problem, yeah. Do you mind?
Sure.
If I
sure,
ask
sure.
You?
So if you want to
thanks a lot.
Want to ask full questions, you can go to the fabulousclass.com. There you can see the context of Mr. Felix. So Mr. Felix, I should say no more than me.
Oh.
Okay.
Okay.
I did my full name when I visit the Microsoft logo. So Mr. Raden, try to log out from the MEC, login again. Biasanya kan belum update.
Yeah.
Change of your redeem account with the same account. Is that possible? Let's say Miss Adita. Try to log out and login again. Biasanya sertifikatnya ganti nama. Yes, Mr. Raden, gimana?
Sure, I will try. Thank you for the suggestion.
Yeah. So sometimes, you know, it won't be integrated because the change. Sometimes you have to log out, login, like that. Okay, and also for those who have the certificate with different name, I suggest you to try to change your name in the Microsoft.com. And you log out first, you log out from the MEC and try to log in again. Okay, so mostly the certificate will, change its name. Or the next or the other, I should say, alternative, misalkan, oh, udah ganti nama, tapi tetap nggak ganti sertifikatnya, I suggest you to delete the account yang MEC, ya. Yang MEC-nya dihapus dulu akunnya, setelah itu buat lagi, bisa kok, bisa pakai email yang sama gitu. Misalkan tadi ada masalah, oh nama sertifikatnya nggak ganti setelah diganti di Microsoft.com, ganti dulu namanya di Microsoft.com, nanti hapus akun yang MEC, yang dihapus yang MEC ya rekan-rekan, yang Microsoft Educator Center itu yang dihapus. Kalau itu udah dihapus, itu bisa buat baru, bisa masuk redeem code lagi. Okay, I cannot put on my previous Gmail. Sign up dulu, tidak sign in. Sign up ya, Mr. Syam. Bagaimana, Mr. Syam? Kliknya yang sign up, create new account. Okay, berhasil, Mr. Raden. Namanya ganti. Mr. Raden.
Yes,
ya?
Things are totally okay. I'm really happy. Thank you, Mr.
Great, thank you. Yeah, automatically updated. Okay, great. So keep up with the questions. Untuk yang emailnya tadi kurang tidak masuk. pilihnya create new account dulu ya. Kalau misalkan baru pertama kali kan memang belum punya akun, itu klik create new account gitu. Bukan yang langsung. Makanya kan kalau udah punya akun ya, kalau udah punya akun ya of course you sign in. Selanjutnya nanti sign in. Tapi no account, right? No account create one. Nah, di create one ini yang baru bisa pakai Gmail. Seperti itu. Punya saya juga pakai Gmail. Yang personal. Ya, alhamdulillah keuntungan, I should say there's a lot of benefits that I got from being an MIE and also joining the MIE community. Mulai dari dapat email berdomain edu. Seperti email yang guru inovatif ini, saya dapatkan dari pelatihan dari Indonesia, itu langsung mendapat OneDrive Unlimited. Kalau Google Drive ya, Google Drive kan cuma 15 giga, kalau OneDrive itu cuma 5 giga. Tapi karena ini dari Kemendikbud, itu dapat yang unlimited. Nah, jadi teman-teman bisa nyimpan file sebanyak-banyaknya di OneDrive. Ya, cloud ya, memang online. Seperti itu. Dan you can also get access to premium teachers. Seperti misal rekan-rekan di sini yang mengajar di sekolah, or maybe you teach in university. Ketika rekan-rekan harus pakai Microsoft Teams. Nah, Microsoft Teams itu ada dua modelnya, ada yang free dan ada yang premium. Dan untuk yang premium itu berbayar. Tapi jika rekan-rekan punya akun dengan domain Microsoft Education, itu dapat Microsoft Teams yang premium. Keuntungannya apa Microsoft Teams premium? Itu rekan-rekan bisa bikin Microsoft Form, PowerPoint, Microsoft Word langsung di aplikasi Teams. Beda dengan Google. Kalau Google Classroom itu kalau mau buka Google Form, buka dulu, beda. Kalau Microsoft Teams itu satu aplikasi, semuanya tercover. Gitu. Jangan teman-teman mau you want to assess your student using Microsoft Form. Kalau di Google namanya Google Form, Microsoft namanya Microsoft Form. It's the same thing, bentuknya sama, gitu. Sebuah formulir. Kalau di Microsoft Teams itu nggak usah buka website baru lagi, tapi langsung integrated in the Microsoft Teams. Like that, yeah. This is outside or inside Golden English teaching, yeah. Because I believe that you teach in a lot of institution, yeah. I know as a teacher, you will teach a lot of students. Yeah. Sometimes we teach more than students, right? And I believe so. There are professionals here. Ada beberapa rekan-rekan yang memang seorang profesional. Yang mungkin seorang manager or HR, because I met a lot of part-timers. Ada beberapa part-timers yang memang seorang manager, and also like they are human resources division, and they want to teach English. Yeah, you can do a lot of things okay. Nowadays. Okay, ada lagi keluhannya rekan-rekan? Yeah, thank you Miss Adiba, thanks for coming, thanks for attending this session. Hope to see you next time. Okay. It's already 1.5 hours. Okay. I think that's all for today. That's all for our session. If there's no more question, and if you have more questions, maybe you have trouble or problem with logging in or signing up to the account, kindly contact the website on fabulousclass.com. Yeah, it will be on the slide. Jadi nanti ada di PDF yang akan saya kirim setelah ini. Dan di PDF itu ada link yang bertulisan biru. Kalau ada yang the blue sentences atau blue link, itu bisa di klik ya, begitu. Nanti langsung masuk website. So for the closing, let's take a Zoom fee or Wi-Fi selfie together in this Zoom meeting. So hopefully for those who can try to open their video or start their video, try to kindly do. Come on, we have 40 participants here. Okay, I'm ready. Okay, thank you for coming again, Mr. Riana, Mr. Dante, yeah. Also Mr. Dede, Mr. Wardoyo. Mr. Wardoyo always coming, yeah. Thank you to our session. Okay. Hey, Mr. John, could you please kindly turn on your video for a moment? So we're trying to take our picture together. I think Mr. John is going somewhere. Okay, I'm going to hide non-video participant. Okay, so we're taking the pictures in 1, 2, 3. Okay, one more. 1, 2, 3. Okay, thank you very much, everyone. Thank you, Mr. John, for coming and attending this session. Thank you for all Golden English teachers. I hope you can get the benefits. Yeah, I hope you can make use of these sessions and also from the MEC website. Okay, and
thanks
also
a lot, Mr. Fajar.
Yeah, you're very welcome, Ms. Maharani. Thank you for coming. And also for the slide, it will be sent to the group. Yeah, untuk slide yang tadi bisa dikirim ke akan dikirim ke group. And also for the recording, you will you can watch it again or rewatch it again in YouTube. Okay, we will send you the link. Okay. Once again, thank you for coming. Thank you for your participation. Have a good day. Have a good weekend. Stay safe. Stay care. Good luck for
you too.
Us. Okay. Thank you. See you.
Thank you, Mr. Fajar.
Thank you.
Bye, everyone.
Bye. Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
Good weekend. Thank you, Mr. John.
Thank you for inviting me to. See you tomorrow.
In the global classroom.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to end the meeting.